Hi everyone, my name is Joyce and today I'll be bringing to you the cabin crew's secrets to frequent flying. And right here, I have a list of products that I've been using for the past 2 years. So I wish that I knew these products before I started flying so that I wouldn't face so much breakout and dry skin and have no idea what was wrong. And hopefully this video will help you before you start flying, so that you can be well prepared and not have to go through the pain like me. Alright, so the first product I would like to mention is Urban Decay Hydra Charge Complexion Priming Spray. Okay, the name is so long and it's trying to confuse you, but it's just mostly coconut water, so it's something that's hydrating for your skin as well as the priming spray. So this is how you use it. It smells amazing, it smells like coconut and I really love the smell of coconut. So instead of going like this, you want to get everything on your face. So that's how I usually use it, like 3 sprays and that is enough for the flight. So I used to use this kind of thermal spring water spray. Don't mind my ugly nails, I've been working hard. Okay, so I used to use this kind of water spray throughout the flight because the bottle is quite small, it's only 50ml and I can just spray it whenever my eyes feel dry especially. But the thing is, after a few hours, your makeup kind of just start cracking because it's just water. This is good if you're trying to just stay hydrated throughout the flight, but this is better if you're trying to look fresh after 12 hours of flying with your makeup still intact. If you want to find it, you can find it at Sephora. And it's kind of expensive, so I try not to spray more than 3, you know. I just want to make sure that I get everything, which is why you tilt your head when you're spraying it instead of going like this, you know. You get all on your shirt, yeah. So I hope you get the point. Alright, so for the second product, I have a lip balm, which I've been using for quite a while. It's Blistec Lip Medex. I probably got it from US. And I've been using it for quite a while. So it's a bit minty, and I'll just use my finger and put it all over my lips so that it doesn't crack when I'm on board. But another thing that I use this for, which is pretty gross, and you shouldn't say it if you're a girl, but I put it inside my nostril. Sometimes the air in the sky gets really dry and people start bleeding from their nose. But that doesn't happen to me. I just stuff this in my nose. I started doing this probably 1 year after flying for so long, and finally I found the cure to a good rest. So you can do this to any lip balm that you have already, but maybe just do it in the toilet and not with everyone else. Yeah. Okay, so moving on to the third product, which is also about hydration, is my hand cream. So I've been using this hand cream for a while, which is the reason why I'm left with so little. I'll probably need to get a new one. But I really like this smell, it's rose. It's from L'Occitane. I don't want to pronounce it because I don't know how to. But it's very useful. They have the kind that's intensive and makes your hand less dry. As usual, I don't really use this just on my hands, I use it all over my elbows, my neck, sometimes when I just want to pat something to make it less dry. Don't fall for the marketing tricks like, oh, this is only for your hands, and then buy this for your face, and buy this for your feet. You're just gonna spend so much money on things that practically do the same. So for the next product, I have a dual time watch right here that I use wherever I go. Can you see it? It has 2 time. It has 2 clocks. The timing on top is whichever country I'm at, and the timing below is home. So I know that when people are not replying my messages, it's not because they don't love me anymore, but because they're sleeping. Dual time, I know wherever I am. And this has helped me a lot because as a cabin crew, you have to know your time. Like, your passengers might just ask you and you don't want to just do the math in front of them, right? You want to come off professional, and this is a professional watch. So the next product is a mask. As a cabin crew, you can't really put this mask on your face when you're resting unless you want to take out your makeup and then put them back on again. If you're a passenger, that's fine, you know, you can just use wet mask like this. But when I sleep in the aircraft, I use this one. because the air gets really dry and it's dirty. You just want the air to recycle inside here. So the routine I kind of have is put this on my lip and my nose and then like seal it up so that all the moisture is inside. Yeah, so I think most of the cabin crew are already doing this, and I learned this from one of my friends, one of my colleagues actually. So thanks to them, I now sleep pretty well inside the container that all the cabin crew hide when you guys are resting. So now that we have covered mostly all of the, you know, outside products, from your face to your hand to your elbows, your neck, and even your nostrils, there's one product that I've been using to help keep my internal healthy. And it's a grape seed extract, which is actually a supplement. So this is how it looks like. I got mine from Usana. So the grape seed extract actually helps with the blood circulation, especially when you're on board, you know, you get all sorts of like water retention. I don't suffer from jet lag as badly as my colleagues. And by the end of the flight, everyone is sniffing, you know. I feel that their body are kind of weak after flying because you're in this container where everyone is sharing their air, sharing their fart, their burp, their bacteria. And you need a stronger immune system to fight against all this. And I'll probably just take two throughout the flight and I feel strong. So guys, we have come to the end of the video and I hope that you enjoy all of the little tips that I share with you. And if you have any tips of your own, maybe you can just leave it down in the comment section below. And leave this video a thumbs up if you have actually watched it to the end. And lastly, don't forget to subscribe so you never ever miss another video with me. Okay, thanks for watching again. Now bye!